I know that I'm over 600 pounds and I still can't stop eating. Because I have such limited activities in my life, food is one of my activities, so I look forward to it as an event.
We're going to our grocery store. Because she can't fit in the car that good, it's just easier for her to get in the chair and for me to just go in the car.
Come on, Dilly. You have tamales today?
Yeah.
Okay, good. 4 pork, please. I enjoy everything about food.
See these tongs, honey? What I want you to do is I want you to use the tongs and take the top one off and get me the bottom underneath because it'll be fresher.
The smell, the taste, the texture, there is just something about it that excites me.
All right, let's go get a drinky.
I love food so much that I want to eat it all.
Gee.
The only thing I'm getting is the joy and satisfaction of the food for those 10 minutes. I'm living to eat instead of eating to live.
I don't know what kind of drinks they have, but I want.
I am very aware of the damage I am doing to my son through overeating. These last 6 years have probably been pretty miserable for him.
I just can't wait for the day that I don't have to help her every day.
Please don't let me wreck. Oh God. You're getting too close to the edge. Oh. Okay, now I just had a heart attack. Thank you, honey.
I could get on with my own life and live on my own.
I feel like I possibly could ruin my son's life. I gotta get this under control. I think that by me getting rescued, it's gonna rescue him too. I've sat here and prayed for something to save my life, and I don't know what will. Because I'll probably die in my bed one day. And I don't want my son to find me. I feel like I've done enough damage to him that would be the final straw.
Would you be able to reach over me and get these boxes, or do I have to try to get up?
There's a doctor in Houston that does weight loss surgery on people my size. He's my last hope.
You ready?
Yeah.
Good job. Oh, good job.
But he definitely won't do surgery if he can't do follow-ups. So we are going to go ahead and move to Houston.
Oh. Will you be able to squeeze me through the van? Let me sit down for a minute. Oh. I'm never going to be able to get in and out of this van.
You're thinking about it too much. Just do it.
Oh. I've never done anything like this, but I know I have to.
Ouch. One at a time. Oh, okay, now the other one.
This is a gamble because we've never met, and I have no idea if he'll help me or not.
Dilly, you want some beef jerky, baby?
No.
I want to eat some, too.
There aren't a lot of healthy options on the road, and I can't really get in and out of the van, so we have to go with fast food.
And now I'm really hungry. I think I want chili cheese fries and a drink. I guess a deluxe dog with a pretzel bun, okay?
Can I get a deluxe dog?
And chili cheese fries.
And chili cheese fries.
I don't know if I've gained or lost over the last year. I can't believe that I weigh almost 700 pounds.
Oh, God.
Hello.
Hi.
I'm Dr. Nazardin.
I'm Pauline.
So I see that you're 670 pounds. Tell me about your eating habit.
Even when I'm not hungry, I'm still wanting to reach for something. Could be chips, or it could be cookies, or it could be ice cream. Even if I'm physically full, I'm still wanting to snack on, you know, something.
Cookie, chips, ice cream. The next question is, who buys those?
I'll send my son, but I know what you're gonna say, and it's really not his fault. I know he's probably considered an enabler, but I abuse my position as his mother, and I tell him, go get my food, okay. And I force him to do it.
You know, the solution is not to buy it.
Right.
Okay, so you already know the solution, you already know the answer, you already know the problem, but you have no control over it. Pauline doesn't see her own responsibility in her current situation. So the question is if she even wants to change right now. Unless we get a handle on the compulsive eating, we're not going to benefit from surgery. Because weight loss surgery is only going to limit what you're going to eat in one setting. This is going to be very hard to treat. For your condition, you should go to a zero carb diet, and I want you to lose 50 pounds over the next couple of months. If she hasn't lost any weight when I see her next, we may have to take more drastic steps because she cannot survive much longer like this. How old are you?
I'm 50.
Do you think you're gonna make it to 60?
That's what I'm worried about. Every day I'm worried that I won't wake up the next day.
It's all her choice, and I don't think she gets that. This is totally on your shoulder to break your eating habit, okay?
We discussed it before we came, and he's on board too. We're both gonna do this.
All right.
Thank you.
Sure.
I was so scared he was gonna send me away, but he didn't. Are you in? Good. I'm in.
I'm not happy that he didn't say that I'm approved, but I am happy that he's willing to give me a chance. It's been a hard month.
My days are so boring because I feel like I'm not established here like I was in California. So I am doing nothing all day. It's boring as heck. My only physical activity is walking to the bathroom from my bed.
I've mostly been stuck in this chair.
How about some chicken salad? With ranch and a Coke, please.
I've been trying to eat better, but there still is mostly just fast food around, so that makes it tough. We're headed back to the doctor's office to see how I've done in the last couple of months. I've been really anxious to get approved.
Push it, baby. Okay. I really feel like I want to pass out already. It's gonna be bad having to walk to the scale.
I've been trying to do what I need to lose the weight.
Children, I just want to fall down.
You went up.
Okay, well, I don't need details. I just want to know if I can get down.
I can't believe that I gained a couple of pounds.
I've had a few things not good for your diet, but I certainly don't feel like I've overeaten.
All right, how's everything going?
Just been feeling kind of nauseous and dizzy and...
How is the thing going with your activity?
I haven't done a lot of activity in the last week because my stomach hurts.
I don't think you're getting how serious this situation is.
Well, I do have a problem with water retention. It may not have been water weight.
Pauline, you gained weight and you're getting to be 700 pounds. Things need to be changed now.